Today, I'm going to show you how to use Framer, which is an application that allows you to design and prototype apps or websites very easily on a web browser platform. I'm going to be using Chrome on my iMac there to show you how it works. It's a free application and you get access to 3 projects and the ability to share with 3 team members who can equally log in and view and edit the designs as you're working on them. If you do want to work with a larger team, you can upgrade to the pro version, and that comes in at around $30 per month. So that might be a good option for those of you in a larger business. In this video, I'll show you how I've been using Framer to put together app prototypes, including the overall design concept and also the interactivity, allowing me to demonstrate screen builds, transitions, and all of the interactivity of the app using Framer, and also how you can very easily share it with other team members to get the feedback that you need in order to progress to the next level. You can build a fully functional prototype that's very easily shared online with your team members, and your developers could then proceed to the next level and turn this prototype into an actual application. So without any further delay, let's go ahead and check out how to build a prototype using Framer. So I'm on the home screen of framer.com website, and to start a new project, you can simply select the plus new icon in the middle of the screen. If you like, they have created a few interactive tutorials that you can explore in your own time. In this video, I'm going to give you an overview of how to get started and create a portfolio app using Framer. So let's get started by clicking on the new icon. And when you do that, you'll get an option to select from one of the pre-configured templates, which includes some great layout ideas if you're looking for some inspiration. But we're going to go ahead and click the blank template option. So we're on the main interface of the Framer application now. I'm going to select the plus button to insert. And you see you have a whole range of options on the left-hand column here of the pop-up screen, allowing you to add different components. We're going to start by choosing a screen. I'll select the iPhone. If I was targeting tablets, I could select the tablet option, laptop or desktop computer, depending on what device or type of computer that I was developing my application for. As I mentioned earlier, this is an iPhone app, so I'm going to select on the iPhone option, and we now get the iPhone 12 screen here by default. If you are targeting a different generation of iPhone, you can head over to the right-hand column here and select from a range of different iPhones, right down to the iPhone 11, 8, iPhone SE, and you can even choose Android and Google Pixel phones, depending on what your target device is. And as you can see further down, you get a range of laptop and desktop computers, as well as the Apple Watch to choose from. So pretty much most of the mainstream devices are covered. And when you select this option, you get the default size of the canvas, which is really useful when you're designing your project. So I'm going to change the background color from white to black by tapping on the fill icon in the right-hand column, and we're going to change that to black. Now, just quickly, when we're ready to preview our project, we click on the play icon just above the frame or in the right-hand corner of the screen, and you'll see we get the surrounding iPhone template around our device, and we can go into the settings and we can change from the dark theme to light theme. We can also go for a horizontal display, vertical, and we can opt to place a hand over the phone and even change the background color to any color we like for previewing. So we can also select the touch cursor option, which will display a cursor as we're interacting. So now that we've done all that, we're ready to go ahead and design our application. To begin with, I'm going to create a preloader screen. Click on the plus icon on the top of the screen, click into the utility option under components, and we'll select one of these loading indicators, select insert, and drag that icon onto your loading screen. I'll make that a little bit larger by selecting and dragging, and we'll place that in the middle of the screen. We'll also place some text on screen, and we'll call this folio. That's going to default to black, so we'll go to the right hand side here and change the color of our font to white. And we'll also need to increase the size of the font to around 30 pixels. And we're going to select it and place that just above our preloader. The next thing we're going to do is create another screen so that we can go from our preloader into our main interface. So we'll tap on the insert icon again, and we'll select the iPhone option in the middle of the screen. And again, it defaults to white, so we'll go into the right-hand section here, change the background to black. And we now have two screens for our iPhone prototype. The first thing I'm going to do is hook up the screen so that when you launch the application, you can go from the preloader screen directly into the main interface. We're going to select the first iPhone frame. And when you do that, you'll get a connector point that appears on the right-hand side of the frame, which we can drag across onto our first screen. When you do that, an interaction screen will appear, and you can nominate whether that interaction occurs on a tap, or whether it appears automatically, or whether it's driven by a tap on the keyboard, mouse enter or mouse leave, for example. I'm going to select the appear option so that it appears automatically, and then I can determine after how many seconds that first screen should appear. So after the preloader, I would like it to appear within 3 seconds. And then we can animate the transition with a number of different options. You can have an instant transition so that it happens instantaneously, push, modal, overlay, fade, or flip. I'm going to select the push option. And then when you do that, you could change the parameters of the animation. We're just going to leave the default for now. And you can also change the direction of that push, from left to right, right to left, up and down, and so on. So for the first example, I'm going to push from left to right. And once we've done that, we can then click on our first frame and tap on the play icon. And you'll see that we get the loading screen. And in 3 seconds, we've now animated across to our home screen. There's nothing on the home screen right now, so we're going to import some photos. And to do that, you simply need to drag them onto the web interface. So I'm just gonna move my screen aside here for a moment, and we're gonna go and find the photos, which I've already prepared in web resolution, so they're not too big, easy to upload. And I'm gonna go and drag a handful of photos onto the main page here, ready to be inserted into our layout. When you're working with lots of different assets on the screen, you can minimize the screen size so that you can play with your layout. So I've just done that by selecting the Command minus key. And I'm going to make those photos a little bit smaller by selecting them all and just contracting them in. Now I'll click on Command plus to get to the larger screen. And here's all the photos I'm going to be adding into our interface. Now there's more photos than there is screen real estate. So what I'm going to do is create a scrolling section on the iPhone interface to scroll up and down within those photos. And there'll be thumbnails that will then click through to the full large image. So to add a scroll section, click on the scroll icon above and place it onto the phone screen. And we are now going to create a new frame that will contain those photos to be scrolled in that area. So select the frame option above, draw out the size of the frame on screen, and you want to match it to the width of the iPhone itself, which is 390 pixels. You can see that on the right-hand column here. So frame, width, 390 pixels. And we can just check that our scroll area is also 390 by clicking on that and checking the field in the right-hand side. So they are all consistent there. We might make this frame a little bit longer so that we can add all of our photos in. And now we can drag all of our photos into the scroll frame, line them up vertically, We're going to need to make that frame a little bit longer to add the last two photos. And we're going to change the background of that frame to black so that we don't have an unsightly white background appearing in our interface. So the elements we have now are the iPhone layout screen itself, a scroll panel, and a frame which contains all of the photos that we'd like to scroll up and down in the interface. The next thing to do is to tap on the scroll area and on the circular icon that appears on the right hand side, drag it across to our new frame. There's all our photos. And the one last little touch that I'd like to make is to put rounded edges around the photo border rather than having them as square frames. So to do that, you can click on each photo and in the radius section, we'll enter a value of 20. Click on each photo to do the same. So let's go back to our first preloader screen. Click on the play icon above or in the top right-hand corner of the screen. Let me just maximize the screen so we can see the whole interface. Click on the play button. And now if I enter the mouse in the screen, you can see I can scroll that content up and down. If you like, you can change the height of the frame to full screen. Let's preview that again. You can preview your work in real time on any screen. So previously we were on the preloader screen. Now we're on the home screen. I can click on the play icon there and we're straight in the home screen. And now we're getting a view of the interface with a full screen scroll of all of my photos. The next thing I'm going to do is to create one more click through so that we can click on each photo within that scrolling range of thumbnails and go to an actual photo landing page, which has a full screen photo. So to do that, we're going to create a new frame and we're going to make it the same dimensions as our iPhone screen, which has the dimensions of 390 by 844. So we'll click on the frame and give it a width of 390. And we'll change the background color. And now we'll drag that first photo out of the frame by holding down the Option key, which means that it's making a copy of the photo and then releasing it. And now that we have that, we'll enlarge it and we'll drag that photo into the center of the frame. And now we're going to make another connection from that first thumbnail into our new frame. And on tapping the thumbnail, we're going to generate a push, and this time we're going to make it slide up the screen rather than left and right. So let's just go back to the beginning. On our main iPhone 12 interface, we have a connection to the scrolling frame, and then on our first thumbnail, we're connecting that to our first image. And then we can repeat that with all of the images by creating another frame. You can duplicate frames by holding them with the Option key and moving them down. Grab the photo, replace the previous one, and again, make the connection from the thumbnail to the enlarged image. And the interaction pop-up will appear, and we'll leave it as tap, push, and direction up. Now, before we go ahead and preview, I'm going to create a back button so that when we're in the enlarged view, we can navigate back to our main interface. So to do that, we're going to insert an icon, click on the plus button above, select the graphics icon under components, and you can choose from a number of different icon options available. Let's choose the phosphor icons and click insert. And the icon has appeared right here on that frame. I'm actually going to move it across to appear on the enlarged section. And on the right hand side, we can change it from a house to an arrow. We'll make it a little bit larger. We'll change the color, which is defaulted to purple, and make that black. And to make that navigate back, you have a number of ways of doing it. You can just select the join icon that appears to the right-hand side and drag it back to our iPhone 12 home screen. And again, the interaction screen will appear and you can select from the transitions. I'm going to stay with the push theme, but this time I'm going to use a left direction to take it back home. So we now have a way of navigating back to our home screen. As your prototypes become more complicated, it's a good idea to name your screens. So let's go and name them by clicking on the layer for each screen on the left-hand side and give our screens a name. So this one's called the preloader. This one can be called homepage. This one can be scroller. This one can be called photo. This can be called photo too. So we now know what each one of our screen represents. It just makes it easier as we're working on our project. So I'm going to go back to the preloader screen, click on it, and then click on the play button icon to preview our prototype. And as you can see, the loading screen appeared, followed by the landing page. And now I can use my mouse on screen to swipe up and down to view all of those thumbnails. And if I like, I can click on those first two images and I can click on one of the thumbnails to show the enlarged image, then click on the back button icon that I created to go back to the main interface. So that is a very basic prototype using the Framer application. There's a lot more you can do in this app, but for this very introductory tutorial, I just wanted to show you the basics. The other great thing about this is you can actually share your prototype ideas with other team members all over the world. So to do that, all you need to do is click on the copy link option and send that via email, or exit out of the preview screen, go back to your main interface and select the invite option. And then you can enter the email address of the team members that you'd like to invite. And you can use the drop-down list on the right-hand side to determine whether your team members can only view your prototype or could edit it alongside with you as you develop your concept further. Thanks for watching. Hopefully you enjoyed this video. If you did, feel free to hit me up with a like and consider subscribing to the channel, and you'll be notified of up and coming video releases. See you on the next one. Bye for now.